And yeah, they're still up. Shouldn't we be in bed by now?
I'm waiting for Santa Claus to come.
So that's it. And you did a good job this year? Well, what about, you should have a little short Christmas story now.
Okay.
Well, let's see here. Once upon a time, there was a man named Danny. Now, Danny was a very busy man. He worked hard at his job, was a loving husband, and a proud father of three lovely and energetic children. And since it was Christmas time, he was busier more than ever.
Hey, Carol, where the heck did I leave my glasses? I was sworn I left them up here.
Check the top of your head.
Thank you so much.
What would you do without me? And where do you think you're going? We've got 5 minutes to load up the kids and get to church. Did you forget again? Tonight's the Christmas program. Now help me grab the kids and let's go.
Oh, I totally forgot. But you go ahead with the kids. I've got something really important to do. I'll meet you at church later on.
No way. You're not sticking me with the three kids again. All by myself. No way.
Please. Really, please. Okay. If you have to know, it's because it has something to do with a special gift for you and the kids, too.
Oh, all right. I don't even know how good you have it. Come on, kids, let's go. Kevin, Kristen, Daniel. And you better not be late.
I wouldn't think of it yet. Come on, everybody, let's go. You guys are going with mom to the church. I'll meet you there later on. Kevin, help your mom out. Got your permit? Where's Danny?
I think he's in the bathroom. He's been in there a while. I saw him take a few comics in there too. Are you really coming to church tonight? You're not going back to work, are you?
Work? No way. I'll be there. Don't worry. Now you better get with mom to the car. Help her out. I'll see you later on. I'll get Daniel. Daniel! Come on, Daniel! Everyone's waiting for you. Yes, I'm coming. I have to do something really important. I'll meet you at the church later on.
You're going to work again, are you?
I'm not going to work. Sheesh. Don't worry, I'll be there. I know you've been practicing. I even heard you singing in the shower.
And so Danny watched Carol and the kids drive off to church. As soon as the car was out of sight, Danny jumped up the stairs, began frantically wrapping Christmas gifts. Big gifts and small gifts, she pulled them all out of the tightest of hiding places. Oh. Here.
Danny? Danny? It's time to wake up.
Anyway! Who are you and how'd you get in here?
I am your angel of Christmas presents. My name is Sheldon. And what, pray tell, is so amusing?
My angel of Christmas present, named Sheldon.
Okay, that's good. Where's the video camera? Did Carol and the kids put you up to this?
No, I am your angel of Christmas present, and God sent me here to help you.
Help me? How are you going to help me?
God understands your situation, your frustration. That's why I'm here.
Frustration? What frustration? Obviously, I have everything perfectly in control. Yeah.
Is that so? Let's talk about control here. Let's see. I see that you're really in control of your time over at work. How about all that overtime that you've been doing? So much overtime, in fact, that your kids spend more time talking to you from the office than when they talk to you at home. Speaking of talking, by the way, when was the last time you talked to God? Maybe this is a clue. Happy Xmas. Okay, now what, pray tell, us is Xmas? Are we talking algebra here? Are we talking about that TV show that's after The Simpsons? No. You think that all these is going to make up for all those missed basketball games, all those missed recitals, all those missed family dinners, and all those broken promises?
Hey, Sheldon. You're a funny-looking angel. Like, where are your wings anyway?
Wait a minute. Do all angels have wings? Did Clarence and the Wonderful Life have wings? Did Michael Lennon and Highway to Heaven have wings? Does Tess and Touched by an Angel have wings? I mean, should I be at least blonde hair and blue eye? I mean, look, you're an Asian male. What, did you get your hair cut with a bowl? Are your glasses like all the rest of the Asian males? How do you like these, by the way? Randy Emory, a Washington Grove. <Bulldogs. laughs> Let's start over. God has sent me here. My name is Sheldon. I'm your angel of Christmas present, and I'm here to help you.
Alright. And I'm Danny. Okay, so how exactly are you supposed to help me?
Well, we have some places to go, some people to see, and as always, the final decision is up to you.
Places to go, huh? So where are we going? Hawaii? Cancun? Fiji?
Not exactly.
With that, snapped his finger. They were at church.
Whoa, how did we get up here?
Don't worry, they can't see us.
Count me hither.
If you can figure out the word hither means. See?
See what?
It's an empty chair next to Carol. She saved it for you.
And now I'm here. Thank you very much. Hi, Carol. You thought I was going to be late, huh? Well, here I am.
Carol, remember, she can't see you. They can't be seen. We can't be seen. Just go ahead and watch this first thing. I don't want you to miss it. Have a seat.
Yeah.
Seems like it was only yesterday that this another performance we don't want to miss. Sympathize with Carol. You really do know how to make your presence known, for the right or wrong reasons.
Hey,
great. I'm so proud of you. Kristen?
Oh, yeah, I'm not really here, right? So they can't see me, right? You know, this program has not been so bad so far. You know, when I heard who was in charge of this thing, I thought it was going to stink. But let's go sit down and see who's next.
You still don't understand, do you?
Understand what?
We're not here to see the Christmas program. We're seeing you here one day making promises again. You promised your kids and your wife that you wouldn't be here. All those gifts that you got them are nearly as important as the fact you broke another promise. They wanted you here at the Christmas program, not those gifts that you bought them.
But this is Christmas. And gifts are important at Christmas. Kids need their toys at Christmas. What is Christmas without the kids getting their toys?
Well, I think Holly can answer that question for you. Holly?
You can see you later,
pretty much the same as they were.
Well, your family wasn't very well off back then. They could often barely make ends meet. In fact, they often knelt down on their knees with the stack of bills in front of them to ask God for means to pay for them. And he always faithfully answered those prayers and provided. Do you remember what your father and mother gave you and your bro for Christmas that year?
Well, no, I think I was too young at that time.
Well, your dad was scheduled to work that Christmas day, but even though he knew he needed the money to pay for the bills, he turned it down in order to spend Christmas the way it's meant to be spent, with his Heavenly Father and his family.
Wow, you know, I don't even realize how much my dad sacrificed.
Your dad and mom sacrificed so much just so that you and your brother would realize how important it is to provide a Christ foundation for each of your own families. I know you'd like to stay longer, but we still have another destination to go to. Ready?
Thank you.
pleasant to meet. Carol, you know, I'm not getting too much done right now. I'm going to take a break with them, okay?
All right.
I'll be back in a few minutes.
All right.
Man, someone got it bad.
Well, I don't know, you know, I can't help it. She's, look at her studying. She's so beautiful, and I just can't concentrate on my studies. And, well, you know, Christmas is coming up, too, and I really want to get her a special gift.
Get a special gift for who?
Well, anyway, you know, I just wanted to...
Get your groove on!
Wait a minute, that's the wrong song.
Do this.
settle guy.
Hey, don't you recognize him?
I'm supposed to know him?
Oh my goodness, it's me? How did that happen to me? That can't be me. It can't be Christmas. Where's Carol? Where's the kids? Where's everybody?
Ben. That Christmas, you were working all that overtime. Didn't see any of your family. But to make up for it, you thought, hey, you could get them Christmas presents. And remember, you spent all that time wrapping them when you should have been at the Christmas program. Oh, you missed it! From that time on, Christmas became about giving gifts. You lost. You forgot the true meaning of Christmas. This was passed on to your kids, and that's why you find yourself gone. All alone. Well, that's why you find yourself all alone. But between your missing the Christmas program and all those elaborate gifts, your kids, they got a really askew, twisted idea about what Christmas was all about, you see. Or shall we say, Xmas.
Oh, wait, no,
I got one more line.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Christmases together. But no longer was Xmas about giving commercial gifts. to make up for lost time and lost opportunities. But Christmas was not a time of rejoicing in the holy infant's birth, the birth of the Son of God, the greatest gift of all. And that, Danielle, is the end of the story, but what do you think?
So does that mean Christmas is really about Jesus' birth and not about Santa and gifts?
I reckon so.
Well, in that case, I should tell Mama Dad to return those golf clubs we got you.